What was once A.P. Carter's grocery store, his daughter Janette has built a museum. It's filled with all variety of personal mementos, right down to the nails A.P. used to hold up his pants. It's part of a memorial to the late Alvin Pleasant Carter, his wife Sarah, sister-in-law Maybelle, and what the trio did in nearby Bristol, Tennessee on August 1, 1927. In a makeshift studio above a shoe store, they auditioned for a record company talent scout. They signed a contract on the spot and went right to work. Those who keep track of such things measure the history of country music from that day in that place.
Whether it's in the west or the north or south or where, even overseas, they could relate to those songs, put themselves in those same shoes, you know, saying is.
They done love songs, they done blues, they done hymns, they done spirituals, and whatever they done, it still had the Carter family sound to it.
Keep on sunny side, always on sunny side, keep on sunny side of us.
In an area of the country where five states share the beauty and poverty of Appalachia, A.P. Carter listened, learned, and then recorded the music of his friends and neighbors.
You'd see a house or something, you'd be driving along in an old car, and an old house that looked like it wouldn't have a roof over their head hardly. He says, well, we'll go up there. I'm sure them people will know a song that I can use, and nine times out of ten, it'd be that. You know, he'd ask them what they know, and he maybe wouldn't get a thing, but maybe the chorus or just a tune, and he'd come home and...
He was a collector. He was classified as a collector, I guess, more than a writer. He was both. But you have to have collectors, too. If people don't collect these things, like I collect things for the museum, if I don't collect the Carter family things, they'll be gone.
Some 250 recordings later, following A.P. and Sarah's divorce, the original singing Carter family disbanded. Maybelle and her daughters went on to success with the Grand Ole Opry, which is where daughter June Carter met Johnny Cash. A.P. returned to his roots in Southwest Virginia, where he died in 1960, but not before his daughter promised she'd try to keep his music alive. She's been doing a pretty good job of it for 25 years, every Saturday night.
The name of it is the Carter Family Memorial Music Center. It is a living memorial to our people, you know, Mother and Daddy Maybelle.
Many years ago we parted, my little Ruth and I, from the sunny mountainside. Carry me back to old Virginia, back to my old mountain.
The rules of the house: be true to the past and be family friendly. In other words, no electric guitars and no alcohol.
Ask any old-timer from old Cheyenne Railroad in Wyoming, the best in the land. The long steel rails, a charred cross tie, landed on the great divide.
With its dirt floors, bus seats for chairs, and air conditioning by God, the hall doesn't look like much, but it fits the music, and it fits the place, called Poor Valley.
They grandmas and grandpas and these children, these college students and these whole families. So that's something that I said I was going to do. The music wasn't going to change, and it was going to be, it was going to be clean. It was going to be orderly. There was a young couple come down there the other night that just walked in and wanted to be married, you know, because they had met there. And when they got through, I didn't know them two, man and woman. And I went over and shook hands with him, and I said, I hope you'll have all the happiness in the world, both of you. And he said, that's why I wanted to get married here. He said, there's so much happiness there. And I said, well, if any of this will rub off on you, I'm glad you got married here.
And the dark waters spring from the black rocks and flow.
Sometimes Jeanette's son Dale joins in the fun, and there's always a visiting band, and almost always Joe Carter's comedy routine, the Barnyard Fight. But Jeanette and Joe are in their 70s now. Dale and his siblings all have their own families and careers, so no one's sure whether we're nearing the end of this particular country road, the one to Carter Country.
Well, we hope it goes on, honey, but I hope so.
Just have to wait and see what happens, you know, no one can tell.
Now let's do one more, and then we'll bring out our band for the night, the Wildwood Flyer. These music shows are presented each Saturday night to keep alive old-time music. As a child, I remember sitting on the porch in the late evening, listening to my mother and daddy play and sing. I know I am growing old, but I want to relive again those precious memories and let my children and my neighbor's children enjoy this heritage.
Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten all the way. If we keep on the sunny